Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how you can create a pop-up in your GetResponse account and how you can add it to your WordPress website in a very easy way. Stick with me till the end of this video and you'll see why. We are now in the GetResponse account and what we need to do is to go to Tools on the top left and then we will click Forms and Pop-ups. I already have a few created here, but to showcase to you, let's click Create on the top right. You will then see this message here. We will focus on pop-ups today and we will just click continue and you will be taken to the page to pick a template. Let's just pick one from here and you can full preview or just use template. Let's use the template. Now we are in the editor and you might already be familiar with this kind of editor. It's a drag and drop, very easy to use. And you have the main page here, what people will see at the beginning, and then if they, in this case, if they would submit their email, they would be taken to this page by default. They would see this, not exactly to the page if you are not redirecting. Although now you have here the global design, in this case, pop-up design, and you have four options here, slide in, pop-up, full screen, or just a bar. And I will showcase the four to you. And then you have positions here where the pop-up should be. And then just basic settings that you will need to design a nice template. And let's move on to add elements. This is the one that you will drag and drop to the template itself. And let's say if you want to add a divider, this is how it would look. And then you can just delete, just as in any of our editors, you would do the same. Let's now move on. You can pick different rules for your pop-up to be displayed. Make sure to check them and I will showcase a few to you. And just so that we can move, let's go to the targeting. You can choose if the visitors are new or returning, the kind of device, mobile or desktop, location. You can just select a specific country if you would like to. And then how often the pop-up should be displayed. And this is where you will select in, for example, N days. During 5 days, it will be displayed. If it should stop on a specific period or when. And also, if you have a specific promo going on a specific time period, you would select here as well. And then you would click Save and you would be taken to this page. And you will see this code here. It's not complicated. This code will be used for every other pop-up that you create. So you will only install it once. So I will click to copy it and then we will get back to it. And here on the domain, I will show you later on how it looks like. Let's now, you would now click Save and Publish if you wanted. And I will want to show you how you can place this code in your WordPress website. It's very simple. We are now in WordPress here. And what you need to find is the code. And you need to go to Appearance and then Theme File Editor, or maybe you have a different name there, but you need to get to this page here where you can edit the theme. And what we need to find is Theme Header or header.php. And you will see the head here. The head starts here and it will end here. All you need to do is to place the code in between. And I did that before and this is the code. So this code is installed now and then you would just click update file here at the bottom. And now let's go back to GetResponse. This is done. I will not publish, but let's check my other pop-ups. As you can see, I have a few here and all of them will work with the same code that we just installed. So we didn't even need to do that again. And let me show you how it will look about the domain very quickly. We would go to edit events here, save, and we would go to this page. It would just look something like this, exactly like your website. In my case, as it will be displayed in the shop page. Let's now see my website. Let's go here. And this is already one of the pop-ups. And let me start from the beginning. You can see the bar here at the bottom. This is one pop-up that we designed. And this one came with a delay of 5 seconds that I set up. It would be to gather some email addresses. And you can, of course, this was just to showcase. You can set different rules. And let's see now how the other ones work. We have on the blog, we have something that will take the whole space just to showcase to you how it would look like if you selected the full screen. And also if we go to shop, and we scroll a little, you will see that the other pop-up will show. It's a very good way for you to target your customers in a very specific way when they are close to convert, if they are already scrolling for a while. It might be what you need to get a sale. And now let me show what we can do if you want to target people who are leaving your website. Let's go back to GetResponse. And here we would edit the web events and we will select on exit. I will not do anything else, just save. And I will go back to my website. I will reload. And okay, it's done. Let's now try to leave. As you can see, it popped up immediately. Certainly a great way for you to incentivize these people that were about to leave your website to convert them and increase your revenue. And remember, it only takes one code for you to manage all your pop-ups. I hope you enjoyed this video and now everything became easier for you. Have a good one.